So in his first U.S. TV interview since the Capitol insurrection, the leader of the Proud Boys makes a stunning revelation about his involvement with Roger Stone. He also tells CNN's Sara Sidner that he has no sympathy for members of Congress who feared for their lives that day.
I'm not going to cry about a group of people that don't give a crap about their constituents. I'm not going to sympathize with them.
The leader of the Proud Boys is talking about the members of Congress who feared for their lives on January 6th.
Everybody stay down!
As a mob attacked the Capitol.
They shouldn't have breached the Capitol with violence.
He says that now.
Fight for Trump!
But the day after the violent breach, Enrique Tarrio posted this, a picture on social media of members of Congress trying to hide as the attackers began their siege.
You write, when the people fear the government, there is tyranny. When the government fears the people, there is liberty. Yes. Doesn't that show that you are celebrating terrorizing people?
I was celebrating, and I'll tell you, I'll celebrate the moment that the government does fear the people. At that point, again, and I didn't have all the information that came in, why they were cowering or anything like that.
Do you
but
wish
I think,
that you didn't do that now that you know
no,
what
I don't.
Happened?
Another thing is I'll never regret something that I said.
They are doing the job that the people put them there to do. And if they don't like it, they can vote them out. They are still Americans. They are still human beings who felt that their lives were in danger. How can you not feel any sympathy or any empathy towards someone like that?
I'm not going to worry about people that their only worry in life is to be reelected.
We got a whole boatload of Proud Boys walking through here, folks.
Tarrio was not there on January 6th. He was arrested in D.C. 2 days before for burning a Black Lives Matter flag stolen from a church and having empty weapons magazines that are illegal in D.C.
You're walking with the Proud Boys to the state capitol.
But a group of Proud Boys was there. The far-right group is known across the country for brawling with members of Antifa.
Antifa.
A left-wing anti-fascist movement. They are also known for throwing their support behind Donald Trump, whose words to them in a September presidential debate exploded their popularity.
Proud Boys, stand back and stand by.
I think we've doubled in numbers since the debate.
Tarrio has close ties with one of Trump's longest-serving advisors and friends, Roger Stone. Stone was in D.C. on January 6th as people rallied against the election results that showed Trump lost. Stone did not march to the Capitol and wasn't charged with a crime. Instead, Stone was seen with members of extremist groups like the Oath Keepers and Proud Boys, who have now become a central focus of law enforcement in the Capitol attack investigation. Tarrio had such a close relationship with Roger Stone, he revealed this.
You have access to Roger Stone's phone?
For a couple times when I went to go see him, you know, I'd help him with like his social media posts and things like that.
Tarrio's access to that phone landed him in front of a federal grand jury, a detail not revealed until now. At the time, Stone was facing 7 charges in the Russia probe, including lying to Congress and witness tampering. Trump pardoned him after he was convicted on all 7 charges. During his trial, Stone was accused of threatening the judge in the case with a social media post, an image of the judge, and what appeared to be a target behind her head.
I testified in front of the grand jury, but no, there was no, that picture was brought up on a Google search, right? So you used to be able to search. Not now, obviously, because
Wait, back up. I just said what you said. Did you just say you were on a grand jury panel? You did.
I did.
It's too late to take it back now.
Well, yeah, that's the story. It's not a secret. That's the story that came out that, they wanted to see if who was it that posted it at that point. The actual crosshairs isn't really a crosshair. It's the logo of the organization that wrote the article. So it was just like a graphic. And then that was posted. I have no idea who actually posted it, but I know that I had nothing to do with it.
Stone is one of the architects of the Stop the Steal rallying cry. But Tarrio does not buy into the lie that the election was stolen. He says he just wants more transparency.
Do you believe that the 2020 presidential election was stolen from Donald Trump?
No, I don't. I don't believe that the election was stolen.
And yet, he encouraged his Proud Boys to show up on January 6th in record numbers.
Here's all the Proud Boys, guys.
A group of them did show up. Here they are, marching together towards the Capitol. At least 8 Proud Boys Tarrio knows have been charged in the Capitol siege. This is one of them, using a police officer's shield to bust out a window in the Capitol, allowing people to flood in.
I condemn the actions. I don't think that he should have done that. I think it was completely wrong. But the other 7 individuals were trespassing. I think that they got caught up with the entire crowd, and they made a poor decision to go in there.
Members of the Proud Boys didn't appear to just be getting caught up in this. Some of them were leading this attack. You had people removing barriers who were Proud Boys. You had someone threatening an officer, breaking the Capitol window. They weren't just following in this insurrection. It appears that some of them were leading the charge.
Now, those 3 accusations, I do want to touch on those. The breaking of the window, we've already hit. The threatening...
You think that's wrong?
Yeah, definitely. Unequivocally, I think that's wrong. But the threatening of police officers, I didn't see that.
The feds have. They have video of William Cressman yelling, "You shoot and I'll take your ass out."
As of right now, I can't tell you about Cressman.
Okay.
Because I can't locate who he's affiliated with, like if he's even a Proud Boy.
Crestman's defense attorney said he was just following Trump's orders that day. But Tarrio says some of his Proud Boys who did breach the Capitol are unfairly being charged with conspiracy.
Did the Proud Boys have a plan to go
into the Capitol?
Into the Capitol.
Absolutely not.
Tarrio put some of the blame for what happened on January 6th on police for being unprepared to thwart the mob.
We're tearing it down.
And he claims some of the Proud Boys simply walked in to record history.
There's nobody that told them that stopped them from going in. You feel like it's something that's wrong that you shouldn't do.
But are you blaming the police for telling people not to break the law?
No, I'm not blaming the cops at all.
So what do you
say? No, I can blame the police officers and the feds for their inability to respond to this. So was it a mistake to even go into the Capitol?
Was it?
Yes.
Do you condemn those people? Can you say that right now?
Okay, I can't say that. Because I think condemn is a very strong word, and I think it's a little bit too strong.
He thinks the FBI is trying to make an example of the Proud Boys. But Tarrio also has a history with the FBI after being sentenced to federal prison for fraud in 2012.
Were you ever an informant for the FBI?
I was, to put it simply, I was put in a very tough situation where the federal government had wanted me to testify against my brothers.
He said he refused, and instead, his defense attorney said Tarrio cooperated with the FBI and other law enforcement on many cases, one involving prescription drugs, another a marijuana raid, an illegal gambling bust, and more. But Tarrio would only admit to cooperating on one case.
The only thing that I actually gave them was the human trafficking ring. And again, I'm not going to apologize for it.
What is next for the Proud Boys and the country? Tarrio has already made a plan.
I think right now is the time to go ahead and overthrow the government by becoming the new government and running for office.
Oh my gosh, Sarah, just stellar reporting, as always, that gives us such a window into this world that we wouldn't otherwise have. So just help us understand that logic. He hates the establishment, I assume, hates the government, but is going to run for office to be in it.
That's basically it. You've got it in a nutshell, Allison. He is himself considering a run, seriously. He did so, by the way, in 2020, but said that because he was dropped by sort of online companies that take in money for donations, partly because of some of the things that he said, that he was unable to do large fundraising, for example. But he is seriously considering running for office. And it just sort of goes to show you, you know, he has a very, very strong opinion about those who are already serving and wants to replace them, but the wording that he uses is really, it sounds violent, right? Overthrow the government by becoming the government. And once you become the government, you also are really responsible for helping the country grow, not breaking it down. So it would be very, very interesting to see where he goes from here, and interesting to see his platform. But he believes that if he runs, as many politicians would, that he will win. Allison?
Look, there's a QAnon follower who was elected to Congress, so anything's possible. Sara, thank you very much. That was really interesting to see your conversation with him.